let us discuss with the reduction of the acids, that is called RCOH. How it is going to be reduced? By using here reducing agent, that is called strong reducing agent, it is called lithium aluminium hydride. Let's see the beautiful mechanism of this acid. So you know this functional group of this acid is RC double bond OH. This is called acid. So what we are going to do? We are going to call this first step is called as a deprotonation. This first step we are going to call as deprotonation. Who is going to be remove this one? That is called aluminium hydride. Lithium aluminium hydride. It is a strong reducing agent. But here it acts as a base. So lithium is highly electropositive metal and this is aluminium hydride. It is called minus. So this basic proton which abstract the acidic proton. So this acid, this carboxylic acid is an acid. So which abstract this proton, what happens? This electronegative difference between oxygen and hydrogen which abstract the bond pair electron towards it, then it becomes RC double bond O, O minus, this minus, and this positive will come attack here, that is lithium plus. Plus what we are going to eliminate here? We are going to eliminate this hydrogen and this hydrogen, that is combining, they are called as hydrogen gas, which is going to be eliminated. And what is the remaining left here? Aluminium with 3 hydrogen, that is called aluminium with 3 hydrogen. So this step is called as deprotonation. This is a very lengthy process, right? Via aldehyde will be formed here. So first step is what? Deprotonation. We are going to, protonation means adding the proton, deprotonation means removal of the proton. So we have removed the proton from this carboxylic acid. Next step is called nucleophilic attack, that is by hydride group. So we should take this product RC double bond O, O minus, Li plus, and this is called this hydride group which will act as a nucleophile, that I will write as aluminium hydride. So this hydride will, this group will come and attack this carbonic function and this migrates towards this oxygen. So that I will write as RCO, RCO, you should write this remaining, that is O minus Li plus, and this is called hydride transfer, that is called nucleophile, this is going to attack this with carbonyl, so that is called hydrogen, will come and attack here, and what is left of here? Only aluminium with 2 hydrogen, that I will write with the bonding with oxygen, that is called, what is the remaining? AlH2. AlH2. So this process is called nucleophilic addition of this hydride ion. So let's take this third step. I am going to this one. So here this group is going to be removed group. So because this oxygen has a minus, this is unstable component, or also I can write 3 lone pair of electrons, they will be acting like this one, stable. They want to become the double bond. So when it wants double bond, the carbon becomes 5 bond. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So which one is going to remove? So this group will be going to be removed. This is called removal of the group. So because the oxygen is having the more electronegative than carbon, which upsets the bond pair of electron towards itself, right? In R O Al S 2 O minus Li plus, and here hydrogen will be there. So this will be group group going to be migrated, and this will come and shift here, then becomes RC, this double bond O, and this will be hydrogen. What I have eliminated here? What I have eliminated here? I have eliminated this one, lithium plus, and this group. Then it becomes O minus, O minus, O minus AlH2, that is O minus AlH2. So this is the third step. First step is called deprotonation. We are going to remove the proton from the carboxylic acid. Second step is nucleophilic addition reaction, that is called this hydride ion, which will come and attack this carbonyl function, or we call this leaving group. Removal of the leaving group. This is called leaving group. So we have seen the three steps: deprotonation, removal of the leaving group. Like this, we have seen. So what is it? Our fourth step is. First step is, once again, it is a nucleophilic addition reaction, because we got the RCH Let's start with the fourth step. We have seen the deprotonation and nucleophilic addition reaction. That is what hydride ion. Third one has seen the removal of the leaving group. So let's discuss with the fourth one. So from the third step, we got this one as a product. That is called, we got the aldehyde. We got, so this aldehyde, once again it containing the carbon function group. So once again it is going to be takes place under the nucleophilic addition reaction. That is once again lithium aluminium hydride. That is called lithium plus aluminium hydride. So this hydrogen, which is going to be attack this carbonyl function, then it becomes O minus. So that I will write here R C H O minus, and this hydrogen come and here. So what is the remaining? We should write here AlH3, I will write here, and also lithium plus I will write. So this is called, fourth step is once again nucleophilic attack. Because of this carbon function, it is a slightly act as electrophile, and this nucleophilic hydride ion will come and attack this carbon function. We have seen in aldehyde and in keto slide. So like this also, we are going to take place in the carboxylic acid. We got this as a last step. That is fourth step. Fifth step is called protonation. How we are going to protonate? With the help of the water molecule. So I will take this product from the fourth group, R CH O minus Li plus with water molecule. That is water molecule. So what happens here? So I require the protonation, means protonation by water molecules. So this lithium plus will go and attack with this OH group. That is called lithium hydroxide, and here this O minus and this H plus will make a bond. So that is called our product RCH2. This hydrogen and this hydrogen are red together, H2, and this O minus and OH. So this is called our primary alcohol. This name is called primary alcohol. So this is a very lengthy procedure to obtain this primary alcohol by carboxylic acid using lithium aluminium hydride. And also we can take sodium borohydride detector as also reducing agent, but among between that lithium and sodium hydrating agent, lithium aluminium hydrating agent has a more tendency power of the reducing power, that is rather than this sodium borohydride. You should know this one. Why it acts as a more reducing power rather than this sodium borohydride? Because when it gets dissociated into the form, because this is a metal, lithium plus, and this is a Na plus, right? So I will write this structure of this aluminium hydride and boron hydride. You know that boron and hydrogen, they will be almost in similar way, because hydrogen contains the atomic number as 1 and boron has a 1 atomic number, right? So this will be the boron atom and this will be the hydrogen atom. There is no bond length, will be always very short between this boron and hydrogen, right? So if I take the aluminium, aluminium is more bigger than this boron, right? I will write aluminium. So this is the aluminium metal. When hydrogen will come and attack this hydrogen, so that is what the bond length will be more here. Bond length will be more, and here bond length will be very less. So due to this bond length shortage in the sodium borohydride, it acts as a less reducing power, and it acts as a more reducing power. So this is the reduction of the carboxylic acid by using this lithium aluminium hydride.